This is part two of solving equations by factoring. So let's summarize. First of all, there's the zero product property, which says if AB equals zero, then A equals zero or B equals zero. That is to say, if you have two things equal to zero, one of those things must equal zero. To solve an equation by factoring, you want to write the equation in standard form so one side of the equation is zero. So by standard form, if it's a quadratic, that's ax squared plus bx plus c equals zero, or it could already be in factored form. Two, factor the other side completely, the side that does not contain the zero. Set each factor containing a variable equal to zero. Solve each of the resulting equations and check each of those solutions in the original equation. All right, so let's do an example. So here's an example. This has an x squared term, so we're going to have to solve this by factoring by setting, first of all, everything on one side of the equation equal to zero. So I have to subtract 8x and subtract 24. And then combine like terms. Okay. Now we need to factor the left-hand side. All right, now this is something that you can do on scratch paper. You have to figure out how to factor x squared minus 5x minus 24. There are a lot of ways to do it. So you should be able to do that any method you like. But when you're done, you should get x minus 8 times x plus 3 is the two factors. Doesn't matter the order you write them in. So now we have it factored and it's equal to 0. Now we take each factor that contains a variable. Well, they both contain a variable. So I take each factor containing a variable and set it equal to 0 because either this factor better be 0 or that factor better be zero. And in fact, you're trying to find all the things that are possible to make this equation true, so that's why we are setting it equal to zero. Or x plus 3 equal to zero. Now we have a linear equation. It's easy to solve for x. So x equals 8 or x equals negative 3. Now let's check this x equals 8 in the original. So the check. We're going to take the original problem, x squared plus 3x equals 8x plus 24, and we're going to plug in 8 into both sides. So x squared, that would be 8 squared. I'm going to write that as 8 times 8 plus 3 times 8. So that's 64 plus 24, which is 88. All right, on the other side, we're going to plug in 8 for the x. So we have 8 times 8 plus 2. And that is, oops, that was plus 24. Didn't copy it down right. That is 64 plus 24, which is also 88. All right, so we know that that really is a solution. All right, let's check negative 3. X squared plus 3x equals 8x plus 24. Okay, let's plug in negative 3 for x. Well, we have x squared, so that's negative 3 times negative 3, plus 3 times negative 3. Plugging in negative 3 for the x's, I have 9 plus negative 9, and that's 0. Okay. On the left-hand side, I have 8 times negative 3 plus 24. That's negative 24 plus 24, 0. Remember, the check, all you're making sure of is when you plug that number in that you get the same number on both sides. So it means it does make the equation true. So there are two solutions here. Both of those are correct solutions. So I'm going to write those. There are two solutions. 8 is one solution, negative 3. Notice this is not an ordered pair. You could just write 8 and negative 3, or you could use the solution brackets like I'm using. That's just a more formal way of writing that there's two different solutions. 8 is a possible solution, and negative 3 is a possible solution. Here's another example. This is a little tricky. The left-hand side is factored, but the right side doesn't equal 0. It never helps to be factored unless the right-hand side is equal to 0. So in this case, we're going to have to multiply this out. X squared minus x plus 4x minus 4 equals 14. Combining like terms, I have x squared plus 3x. And let's see, I'm going to subtract 14 from both sides. So this is minus 4 minus 14. X squared plus 3x minus 18 equals 0. All right, so we have it in standard form equal to 0. Now this is what we need to factor. It's not any helpful to be factored unless it's already equal to 0. So now we need to factor this left-hand side. All right, again, you could do this on scratch paper using any method you'd like. I use trial factors in my head. I'm going to get 6 and 3. Plus 6 and minus 3, that gives me the correct middle term and the correct last term, correct first term, etc. So I factored it correctly. Now you take and set each factor containing a variable equal to 0. So we're going to set x plus 6 as one of the factors equals 0, or another possibility is if x minus 3 was equal to 0. So I get x equals negative 6, or x equals 3. All right, now of course we have to check them in the original. That's all the way up to the top. So we're going to check x equals negative 6 into x plus 4 times x minus 1 equals 14. Okay, I need a little more space here. So we're going to put in negative 6 where the x is. So negative 6 plus 4 and negative 6 minus 1. That gives me a negative 2 times a negative 7, which is 14. And yes, I had 14 on the other side. So yeah, this is correct. That's one solution. Now we're going to check x equals negative 3 into the original equation. Make sure you check it in the original, not the x squared plus 3x minus 18 equals 0, not into the x plus 6 times x minus 3. You must check it in the original equation because you might have made a mistake in between the original equation and some other step. So let's see, we're going to plug in 3 for x. So 3 plus 4 and 3 minus 1 is 7 times 2, which is 14. Yes, they're both solutions. Hip hip hooray. So the solution to this one, I'm just going to say the solutions are negative 6 and 3. That's the solution this time. I'm just not being as formal. It's not an ordered pair. There are two solutions. If you were going to use solution sets, you would just use the braces. Sometimes there are 5 solutions to a particular problem. In a quadratic, you could have up to 2. The quadratic means it's an x squared. Let's try to get one more in. X cubed minus 4x equals 0. All right, well, at least I have it set equal to 0. Now I need to factor the left-hand side. So I could factor out an x first. The first thing in factoring to see if there is a common factor you can pull out. That gives you x squared minus 4. And now, x squared minus 4 is a difference of 2 squares. So I can factor further. X plus 2 times x minus 2 equals 0. So you know what happened in this one? Notice that the degree, the highest exponent is 3. We can still use this method of factoring in the zero product property for something that is not a quadratic equation. We can have it for higher powers. So in this case, we're going to actually get 3 solutions. There are 3 factors here containing variables. This is just simply an x, or x plus 2 equals 0, or x minus 2 equals 0. This is already solved, right? This one, if we solve, we get x equals negative 2, And the other one is x equals 2. Because of time, I can't check all of these, but let's just check x equals 2 in the original. X cubed minus 4x equals 0. Put in 2 cubed minus 4 times 2. 8 minus 8 is 0, and it checks. So the solutions, if you check them all, will be 0, negative 2, and 2. So it's even possible to do these kind of problems.